If you're like me, you hate testing webhooks. When you start testing webhooks, your productivity goes down. When trying to figure out ngrok or local tunnel and making sure it's working as expected is always such a hassle. Well, the team over at Ping have released a new webhook testing tool called Webhook Thing. So let's check it out. So here I have some example code. Let's just talk about what the example code is, and then we can talk about Webhook Thing. So I just have this one webhook here called hello, and it takes the request body first name and just responds with that. It's very similar to the hello API. I also have this pretty complex user add or user update request. And what I've done here is added some headers. Instead of checking for some stuff, I've added headers here that say, if this header doesn't exist, respond back with this. Otherwise, you can do everything inside of here. So in theory, that would be a protection route. Maybe you have to add a bearer token or a token or something to verify that this is an actual webhook with timestamps and all that kind of stuff. So I tried to recreate that as best that I could without implementing a lot of complex code. So we have two webhooks here that we want to test. So how do you test them? Well, first you need to run your server. So let's get our Next.js server up. Then if you run npx webhook thing at latest, you'll get this UI appear on screen, and I'm using Arc, so it's come up in a little window. But you can see webhook thing, and the docs are here if you need them, and then it tells you what address that it's running on. So here is what the UI looks like. Let's talk about all the features of the UI, and then we can show you how it works. So inside of here, you can organize your folders. You can create many folders for all your different kinds of webhooks. So if you're working on a large team, let's say you have 100 webhooks and you organize them by specific functions in your business logic, you can do that. Then you have the option up here to create a new webhook, or you can click this button right here. So let's create our first webhook. So when you create a new webhook, you need to name it something.json. So we'll call this one hello webhook, and then create the webhook. Then you get dumped into this screen here where you get to denote everything from the URL, the body, the headers, and the query parameters if for some reason you have them. So in here we can do HTTP, localhost, 3000 API webhooks, which is where my webhooks lie, and then hello. And then inside of here we can add some valid JSON. So in here we'll just do first name and do James. And then when I hit save changes here, you're going to get this little terminal info here. And now if we go back to our code and take a look, you'll see that this new folder here has appeared, and it tells you what the URL is in your configurations and obviously what the payload is. Now this is awesome for teams. You just commit this to your GitHub repository and now everyone has the same testing. Everybody knows everybody's on the same page. So now if I go back here and hit run, you'll see that it will look for that configuration file. It will send it to the URL you specified, and we got a response here of James. So if we go back to the homepage here and we create a new webhook, and we call this one user add, we create this webhook, and this is on localhost 3000 slash API slash webhooks slash user add. And now we have that, we need a payload. So I've put a files in here with a giant payload with a bunch of stuff that comes from Clerk when you use our webhooks. So I can just dump this in here. And when you hit save here, same configuration. And if I run this out of the gate, you'll get got response. Why are you trying to trick me? And because of that is because in the webhook here, I asked for this kind of header. Now, this is important for when testing webhooks. You want to make sure you've got the right headers. Is it an application JSON? Should it have this or that or whatever? So this is really important to have. So we're going to have that, add that header here, and I can just put in 123 webhook thing is cool. And obviously this would be valid against whatever webhooks you're using. Hit save. And now this configuration has changed. Now we've added the header. If we run it now and click the run button, you'll get got response, response user was created, which is basically this 200 response right here that I've put in the application. If you made it all the way to the end of this video, make sure you click this button right here. It's a video on something, YouTube algorithm, I don't get to decide. And then of course, right here, hit subscribe